Stine. I write the Goosebumps books.
All right, guys. So, I'm planning things. Things are being planned as I speak. 700th video coming up. In 2 videos after this one will be published. 700? 7 days? Maybe? So let's do another Goosebumps episode. This one I remember so vividly as a kid. The Cuckoo Clock of Doom. Which, JTPSA, this is not for children. This is for 18 plus only, even though it is a young adult show. Children, leave now. The whole premise here is that this kid, who has a very annoying little sister, like, sabotages his birthday party. And his father gets this antique clock, cuckoo clock. And when the bird comes out, the kid ends up twisting the head around. And time starts going backwards. And he keeps waking up younger and younger. And he has to try to find his way back to the regular time, his regular age, before he's, like, not even born anymore. It's a great idea. I mean, we've seen this, stuff like this. And like I said in the last video for Haunted Mask 2, so much of R.L. Stine stuff is so derivative of Stephen King, of horror from all over the place. He's not that original of a writer, but he's great at writing the way that he does. Like, for his style, he's perfect. And, I mean, there's no debating. He's one of the like highest-selling horror authors. Or authors in general, something like that. He's really high up, like more than you would expect, R.L. Stine. So, I mean, you got to give him kudos for what he did with creating this entire just property of Goosebumps. But let's talk Cuckoo Clock of Doom. It's so crazy. Every time I watch another one of these, I can just picture little kid me, like after school, sitting down in the living room, sometimes with my sister, sometimes not, watching these. And just the intro always brings me back with that, because it's just so nostalgic. Every episode of this goddamn show, the very first part of the episode, before the first commercial, is always a stupid jump scare that never turns out being anything threatening or anything like that. I think I said this in one of the other videos. The guy, I forget his name, Mike? If that's right, then I'm surprised by my memory, especially right now. I think his name might be Mike. But then his little sister is such a bitch. She's squirting ketchup at him and stuff. And his name is Michael, yo.
What?
Yo.
She's the one. She's,
you gotta give props where props is due. I haven't seen this shit in like 15 years. And he's got the ketchup all over him. And he gets in trouble all the time, and she's like the angel child, and she never gets in trouble for fucking anything, and then she just rubs it in his face like a young little bratty sister always does. So it's Michael's birthday party, and I think he's like 12 years old or something like that. I'm sure they're going to say it in a second, but it doesn't matter. He's a preteen, and the sister is like 10 or something like that. And it's his party, and she trips him right in front of the girl that he likes, like with all his friends there. Trips him, he falls face first into his birthday cake. I would kill this. I would kill my sister. That cake does look really good, though. Blue icing and stuff. Mm. And like with any type of time loop movies, TV shows, or anything like that, we see a lot of the birthday scene. We see it like 5 times in this friggin' episode. There's a lot of padding just to show the same thing over and over again. I mean, you can't really call it padding because it's the story, but it's the same shit over and over again. It's a cool story, though. Like, what happens to him and how he gets back. The cuckoo clock looks cool, though. And then the father saying that the guy he got it from said there was something wrong with it, but he didn't say what it was. So, if I recall correctly, isn't it like, there's like numbers on it that represent years, and like his year is like, his birth year is broken off or something? I don't know, something like that. It doesn't really matter. this kid is, I was this kid. Like, I got a younger sister too. Same age difference, almost, like 3 years. And he goes downstairs, he's sneaking downstairs at night, and the father's yelling at the sister and saying, like, she went near the cuckoo clock. And he's saying, like, if I find anything broken, you're going to be so much stronger. And he's like, yes, yes, yes. Just so happy to hear his sister getting reamed for doing something wrong instead of him for once. That's funny. Yeah, so Michael sneaks back down, and he gets pissed. And he finds a way. He's going to get back at his little bitch sister. And he turns the head of the bird around on the cuckoo clock. And that way, she'll get blamed for it. And then he wakes up the next morning, and it's his friggin' birthday again. Same lines and stuff from the sister. She's so annoying, this girl. Like, she really is. Her voice is just, it's so piercing. It's so annoying. It's another one you just want to punch in the face. Like, it's like, oh, her voice, man. And it reminds me of, like, my sister when we were around these ages. So we have to sit through this whole birthday scene again, and he's freaking out because he's like, yeah, this just happened, like, yesterday. This stupid twat twister of a kid. He ends up, he knows that he's going to get tripped by his sister and fall on the cake. And he's like, not this time. He goes in, he takes the cake, he walks right in, and she gets tripped again, and he falls with the cake in his face. Come on, man. This is like time travel 101. You know what's going to happen. Avoid it. When he's explaining to his parents, they think he's sick. He's like, I'm not sick. He's like, I didn't enjoy my birthday twice now. And he's saying, like, you guys gotta believe me. Like, I woke up and it was 3 days ago. Time to call a doctor, right? Like, immediately is the right thing to do as a parent. Michael, in his dream or whatever this is, him running slow motion down the hallway with the twisty, like, cam for the, it looks so 90s, it looks so bad, but it has some charm to it. And the cuckoo clock starts floating around badly too, and the girl's face, his sister's face, pops out of it. All of it looks terrible. All of it looks hokey, 90s as can be, but it's so nostalgic. Like, I remember all of this. So he wakes up the next morning, and he's 6 years old. He was 12. Now he's 6, and he asks about Tara, his sister. She don't exist yet. So she's 6 years older? I mean, she's 6 years younger than him? She doesn't look that much younger than him. So she was only 6 years old? I guess so. She looked a little bit older. But she's gone. So he should be jumping for joy. Like, and he starts saying time's going backwards and stuff, and now they think something's wrong with him, and the father again is humoring him. That would make a great science fiction story someday. Like he's never heard this premise before. Since it's 6 years prior, the cuckoo clock is gone. The father's saying, we don't have a cuckoo clock. What the hell are you talking about? Like, this kid's freaking out, man, and who wouldn't? Again, doctor or hospital, asylum, something, immediately? No? All right, the 90s. He hated his birthday twice already. Now he gets to relive his 6-year-old birthday. There's a clown there. And this is all stupid, but like, how does the time travel work? He started at 12. He woke up the next morning, he's 6 years old. Well, he relived 12. Then he woke up, he was 6 years old. Then it like jumps and he's like a baby. Like, why doesn't it jump another 6 years and he's zero and he's gone already? Like, I mean, of course, it's because you needed more time for the episode and the story. But all of that is just stupidity. And how does this kid know he's going to find the cuckoo clock at the antique store? How does he know that it's there? How does he know he knows that this place had this clock for at least 6 years? How does he know when his dad bought it, the guy didn't just get it in 3 months ago, a year ago? Like, he's banking on a lot of you. He's saying to his dad, shows up saying, you're not supposed to be downtown alone. Like, yeah, good parenting. And ends up saying to him, and he's trying to say, like, the cuckoo clock, I gotta get to the clock. He's like, I don't even want to hear it. Of course, I mean, this kid sounds insane, and of course he's going to keep humoring him with all this ridiculous stuff he's saying. But as soon as he hears the kryptonite words that a father says to a son that I'm very disappointed in you.
Honey, maybe if you just one.
He just lets it go and walks back home with his dad. He gives up on the clock. And now he wants them, like, it's cute, kinda. He wants them to read stories to him and stuff because he knows when he falls asleep, he might not wake up. He might be gone, you know? Like,
juicy.
So now he's an infant and he shit his pants. He's saying, what's that smell? His parents look like hippies and totally different looks to them. And he's just like a total little infant in a crib with those little things that hang above the babies. So now he's got no chance. How is he getting to a cuckoo clock now? How does he know that it even exists at this point? How can he even think about any of this? He's an infant. Like, I don't know. How would he even have the memories of the cuckoo clock or his future life if this is back in time and he's an infant? I mean, of course, again, ridiculous, but me. We get some, like, funny Bruce Willis is in everything I've been doing lately. He's not this, but we get, like, Bruce Willis, look who's talking type baby thoughts with the infant. Then the actor who plays the kid, Michael, is doing the voice over it, and to the baby, like, doing certain actions. Funny. And they just happen to go to the antique shop with this kid. He's not like a baby, but he's like maybe 1 year old. And he sees the clock. This is the one place they decide to go, man. It is his lucky life. It is his lucky time travel extravaganza. And he starts walking, like, as an infant, trying to walk and get to the clock. And he's climbing up there. And he ends up turning the head back around. That's right. So when he twists the head back around, he accidentally knocks the year 88 off. And then he wakes up the next morning. He's back to 12-year-old normal him. But his sister's gone. His sister doesn't exist anymore because she was born in 88. That's cool. Get rid of your annoying-ass sibling. Goosebumps, Cuckoo Clock of Doom, so much nostalgia. I say this with every one of these episodes, so maybe Night of the Living Dummy 2. Maybe. And then maybe 7 days.
I love you!
Well, I'm...
Beware, you're in for a